In this video, I want to share an adventure with you in finding one of the most amazing forests in North America. There are a couple of things that set this forest apart from other old growth forests. For one, it has some of the highest recorded biomass per acre of anywhere on Earth. You might think that would be a rainforest in the Amazon or something, but it turns out no, it's right here in my own backyard on the slopes of Mount St. Helens. The second thing that makes this forest stand out, it has a very high proportion of noble fir trees. Noble firs are somewhat rare. They only occur in Oregon, Washington, and the very northern part of California. If someone knows them, they would probably say, oh, like a Christmas tree? Yeah, isn't that interesting that this superlative forest is made up of primarily old growth Christmas trees? I knew the general area of this forest, but not the details. It was an area that I had hiked in, but I knew the trails did not lead to the specific stand. After some research, I was able to find a lidar image of the area. So with this new map, I set out to find the forest that I had read so much about. Mount St. Helens is famous for one thing, the eruption that decimated the northern slopes of the mountain. None of the trees survived in that area. And quite sadly, there was a 300-foot-tall noble fir tree that was blasted away. 300-foot-tall trees are a very elite group. Luckily, the Goat Marsh area has a champion noble fir, the highest biomass per acre, and one noble fir that is 295 foot tall. It should be mentioned that tree was recorded at 295 feet tall a couple decades ago, so it's quite possible it's over 300 foot tall today. So a short hike down an unused road leads to where you can enter this forest. Not that much information on mine. The pictures of this Goat Marsh Giant, the biggest noble fir in the world, you know, you can't really find them online. They're just really kind of grainy pictures and stuff. Very unique area on Earth. And who knows, maybe there's going to be another fire, another eruption. You know, it's just, I mean, someone should, I feel like someone should document this area. Here you can see, we're in that area now where they're doing all the tagging. See all these trees, even these little tiny ones here. Research natural area, camping stock and motorized use prohibited. In a research natural area, they can try to figure out what's ideal conditions for this type of tree. You know, and that way they can just leave it and they document it for the future. But there are also these things like, they don't like you like camping in the research natural area because you're disturbing it. They don't want you mushroom picking because who knows, maybe the mushrooms tied in somehow or something like that. It's not obvious where to go in, but once you step through the small overgrown area where the road was cut, you are greeted with an amazing cathedral-like forest. Oftentimes, these tree trunks can rise up over 100 feet before there's even a branch. Most of the competition for light has taken place hundreds of feet up. It was obvious this was the forest I was looking for. We were getting close. The forest density was increasing dramatically as we approached the ideal habitat for noble fir trees. The Douglas fir trees that are growing here grow to over 300 feet tall. How is it that Douglas fir trees outcompete almost all of the trees at this altitude in other locations, but not here? There's something in this area that is approaching the ideal growing conditions for both the Douglas fir and the noble fir, and for some reason the noble firs are outcompeting them. The Goat Marsh Giant itself stands in the middle of a grove of other huge noble fir trees. The trees themselves serve to protect it from wind and erosion. The old decaying stumps of former trees holds hundreds of gallons of water to be slowly released during the dry season. Trees like this would not exist on their own. Pretty sure. So what I ended up doing was I matched the pictures online. Like, they don't give you the location, but I matched the picture online with this, and that's, it was an exact match. And then also you see how it's marked, someone marked it. So I think the picture online is taken from like this angle here. No, it doesn't have many needles at all up on top anymore, does it? So yeah, it's kind of sad that the tree is dying. You can see it succumbing to the same forces that have pulled down countless trees before it. We are lucky that the grove still exists.
The foresters that were working for the lumber company saw the unique qualities of this place when they were doing their calculations. They notified the state, and a deal was made to swap out the land before anything was cut. The eruption of the mountain itself has further blocked off this area, and it serves an example of what a forest would look like without human interference. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I plan on doing more of these in the future.
I was reading that there was another place in by Mount St. Helens here, or another noble fir tree that was over 300 feet tall, but it got destroyed when the volcano erupted. So maybe there wasn't even, maybe there's even a better area.